Hello, ladies and gents, it's me, Clayton. I just got back from seeing the latest My Little Pony episode. It isn't the main thing about you. I know that it's a bit late and that the lighting isn't exactly amazing, but I do think that this is an episode worth talking about, mainly because it manages to take one simple idea, what if Rarity had a punk rock hairstyle, and it manages to use it to make a very memorable episode. Let's get to the story, shall we? The story is that Rarity's mane has been screwed up through a little bit of party string provided by Pinkie Pie, so she goes over to Sakura to try and get some shampoo to make her mane right. Unfortunately, she ends up taking remover potion rather than the actual shampoo, leaving her mane looking like a total wreck. Then she spends the remainder of the episode trying to find a way to restore her mane or try to get a new one before she has to go through a photo shoot with photo finish. So, the thing I really liked about this episode is that it was able to take this simple idea and actually do something with it. And it was able to use that to take Rarity's drama queen tendencies back to the comedic levels that we remember from the days of old. Tabitha St. Germain always does a really good job with Rarity's over-the-top emotions, but here she's allowed to play her really over-the-top in a lot of different ways. Over the top in the way that she hides her mane, over the top in the way she reacts to almost everything around her, and of course, having callbacks to previous episodes, such as her lying on a couch in a certain manner and eating ice cream in depression. But of course, the callbacks don't stop there, as her friends do call back to various events of the show when it comes to them trying to give Rarity back her confidence. Including a reference to the very first episode of the series. It should let you know that Josh Haber has done his homework when it comes to writing for these characters, and he definitely knows what he's doing when it comes to how he writes an episode, even for ones that have simple premises like this. Pinkie Pie was generally entertaining as well. She gets a short little song that's a neat little jingle, and she manages to provide a decent amount of comedy. Andrea Lidman, of course, does a great job, but what I really loved was the fact that we got to see Sakura again. Sakura has always been one of my more dark horse characters, to put it in a simple way, because I really like her character despite the fact that she gets limited screen time most of the time. But Brenda Critchlow makes sure to make every second she's on screen worth watching, as her entertaining rhymes and her strange potions often make her a very entertaining character, and often makes her the catalyst of some interesting episodes like this one. Now, the message of the episode is pretty solid when it comes to the fact that your confidence can be restored even if your hair can't. But I do think that it does feel like it's a message that could have been done earlier in the show, even if these episodes aren't necessarily taking place in chronological order. I just feel like this is an episode that could have taken place more in seasons 3 or 4 rather than 7, though that is more to do with the fact that the series has been going on for so long that it feels like the writers sometimes have to scratch at any idea that they can possibly have for an episode, considering that they've done over 100 of these and they are showing no signs of slowing down. The fact that they were even able to make this many episodes without it becoming boring is honestly kind of amazing to me. So, It Isn't the Main Thing About You is actually a very entertaining episode with some good comedy, some good over-the-top drama queen moments, and of course, an appearance from Sakura. I can think of worse things to do for an episode. I give it a 7.5 out of 10. See you next time.